As environmental pollution becomes more and more serious, solar energy, a clean energy source, is becoming the next energy solution, and a microinverter is an essential part of the residential solar system. To better understand it, we'll take apart this IQ7 Plus microinverter from Enphase today to see its components inside. It adopts a matte plastic shell with mounting holes and input-output ports on both sides. All the specs info are printed on this large sticker. The power factor range is plus minus 0.8. The maximum continuous DC input is 720 watts, and the maximum continuous AC output power is 290 volts amp. And the operating temperature is minus 40 degrees Celsius to 65 degrees Celsius with IP67 ingress protection. It also has passed CE certification. You can pause here to take a look at the details. There are many irregular protrusions and depressions on the back, corresponding to the internal components. In addition to the three ports on one side, there is also an indicator light. The DC input port is on the right side, and the AC output port is on the left. An indicator light is in the middle. The size of the microinverter is about 21 by 12 by 2 cm, and the weight is about 938 grams. After cleaning up the silicon adhesives, let's open the case and analyze the internal components and structure. There are four capacitors on the right, and the inverter transformer is at the bottom. The low voltage MOSFET for boosting and the corresponding driver are on the top, and no components on the back. The DC input from solar batteries can be filtered by four electrolytic capacitors. Those capacitors are from Chemi-Con, which are connected in parallel, 63 volts, 3300 microfarad. And this inductor is also used for input filtering. This 3 milliohm resistor is used to detect the input current. The MOS controller is from Enphase, which controls the boost and output modulation. It can drive low voltage side directly and high voltage side through the isolated driver. And the external memory of the controller is from GigaDevice. Those two buck chips that power the MOS controller are from Texas Instruments. A buck chip marked with 15AD is in here. This is the indicator light. Here is another chip customized by Enphase. Those four MOSFETs are from On Semiconductor and can form an H-bridge for input converting. 60 volts, 2.4 milliohm for each one. Here is the other two MOSFETs. This is a 100 volts half-bridge driver from MPS. It integrates bootstrap diode, which can independently control the upper and lower MOSFETs. Here is the other one. Those MLCCs are used for input filtering. Then this is another set of MLCCs. The circular inverter transformer is from EPCOS. It integrates the secondary current transformer. Those four output-modulating MOSFETs are from Infineon and adopt TOLL package. 650 volts, 102 milliohm. And two dual-channel isolated drivers are on two sides of the modulating MOSFETs. They are from Infineon and are used to drive modulating MOSFETs. The output current transformer is used to detect the output current. The blue-white capacitor can suppress the interference. This is a safety X2 capacitor for output filtering. And the red varistor is from Littelfuse. The common mode choke is composed of two small parts in red and copper color. Here is another same common mode choke. The output fuse is from Littelfuse, 3.15 amp, 300 volts. This is a discharge transistor that prevents overvoltage. Another same Littelfuse varistor. Well, that's all components of this Enphase IQ7 Plus microinverter. After taking it apart, we found it adopts many customized components, including MOS controller, drivers, and MOSFETs. They were from top-tier brands like MPS, On Semiconductor, Infineon, etc. So it can deal with the harsh outdoor environment easily. Okay, that's all for this video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!